हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द इंडियन पॉलिटिकल थॉट ऑफ राम मनोहर लोहिया। फ्रेंड्स, राम मनोहर लोहिया इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया, द पॉलिटिक्स इन इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया। ही वॉज अ वेरी स्टॉन्च सपोर्टर एंड ही हैज अ यूनिक प्लेस इन द एवोल्यूशन इन द सोशलिज्म थॉट इन इंडिया। He rejected both the idea of socialism, that is the Russian idea of socialism and the Western idea of socialism. He said that because India have some unique features as a country, that is why no political ideology can be imposed upon India. It has to be rational in the nature and it has to be compatible with the situation. Whatever the situation, the political, the geographical, the sociological problems of India have unique solution, and that is, it is not possible to solve those problems with the Western idea or Russian idea of socialism. Friends, he rejected both the capitalism and socialism. He said that in both these methods, in capitalism, some people have the monopoly over the economy. In socialism, there are also some people, the leaders of the socialist idea who led the masses, those have the special class of people which have the monopoly over the economy. And that is why he rejected both the ideologies of the political science at that time, whether the capitalist or the socialist. He also gave some examples in this regard. He provided that if you look at the countries which have the socialism established in their countries, they are not so developed. Those countries were not able to provide a substantial change in the society. And that is why he was very much, if you analyze the writings, if you analyze the work of Ram Manohar Lohia, you will find out that he was, even if a one personality, if you want to point out to whom the Lohia was closer, he was Mr. Gandhi. Okay, so he established that political and economic objective of socialism are to establish a free and decentralized society. The word decentralized is very important. The centralization of power, the centralization of economic resources, the centralization of thoughts is rejected by Lohia. Okay, so it is very important. According to Lohia, the true socialism lie in the these fundamental things. Nationalization of big industries. He was supporter that the industries in any country should be nationalized. Kharcha bandhan. There should be a cap on the spendings of an individual. Dam bandhan means there should be a cap on the cost, on the prices of the goods and services. Ban on owning more than two houses. A people should have only the houses, he needs to live into. Okay, there should not be the accumulation of houses for the purpose of capital gains in the long term. Regulation of urban land prices. The prices in the urban area should be regulated by the government, and the prices should be according to the income of the middle class men, or we can say the lower class, lower strata of the society. Ban on production of private cars, because car has become a status symbol at the time of Mr. Lohia. That is why he proposed a ban on private cars. Eliminate different classes in passenger train. He also advocated that this class differentiation among all the things should be eliminated, because this classification, that the class of people actually arises, and the people who are able to afford the higher class or are able to pay higher prices of the things, they sometimes see the people who are living or affording the lower class at some, you know, with a lower attitude. Okay, so socialism appealed to Lohia. It is very pertinent to mention here that many political parties in the independence India have followed the ideology of Mr. Lohia. Parties in the northern India like Samajwadi Party, Bahujan Samaj Party, Bharatiya Janata Party. And I am giving this example here because as a student of political science, you should be able to analyze the intra-democratic nature of the political parties. Okay, it is very important for you to understand the ideology of a party in order to have an insight about the policy implemented by a party. And as I am telling you, Lohia was a very staunch supporter of the socialism. He although he rejected both the idea of Western socialism or the Russian socialism, he said that the socialism of India should be unique and should be able to solve the problems of India. Okay, so political parties in the independent India followed, many of the political parties have followed the words, followed the ideology of Lohia. His numerous writing, he observed that racism is a very, very, very big problem of the human society. Color and white supremacy in the world and human attraction towards the fairness actually is the problem, because this is the fundamental nature of the humankind, that they got attracted towards the fairness, towards the white, and it has been injected their minds that the white people are superior to the black people, and that is the main problem. That is why the Western world actually ruling over the whole world. I have taken here some extracts of the writings of Ram Manohar Lohia. In this paragraph you can see, I will provide you a verbatim. Revolution is specific to our time, aims at demolishing inequality springing from skin color. Aside from material handicaps of productivity or weapon power that belongs to colored skin, the impression prevails that beauty goes with fairness. That was the point I was trying to tell you, that in his writings, Lohia criticized the racism based upon the white supremacy. Not least does this erroneous belief obtain a duskier lens. This downgrading of colored skin is certainly the result of white supremacy in the past 400 years, at least in some measure. Political situations intertwine with aesthetic motions. Now the point is, because the people who are not white, they somehow, we can say, surrender themselves in front of the white people, and that is the reason, because there is a white supremacy in the world. And this is how most of humanity and therefore of humankind is dark. The dark woman is in no way less beautiful than the fair one. For what makes beauty is not the color of the skin, but its texture and figure and features. And that is why we can say Ram Manohar Lohia was a man with the ground. He always go into the deeper side of the things. He always try to find out the feature, the figure of the things. And that is why he also proposed very different things for the political system in India, like the Chokhamba Raj. He tells that there are four pillars of politics in India, the center being the pillar one, province being the pillar two, district being the pillar three, and the villages being the pillar four. And until and unless all of these pillars are not strong, the polity of India will not stand firm. Okay, so according to Lohia, the socialism advocates for equality, people and prosperity for all. It should rely on election, constructive work and civil disobedience. Civil disobedience being the fundamental right of an individual, so that he can oppose the policy of a state, so that the state cannot become an anarchy in nature. So Lohia also proposed that collective development of the society is very important. If people are culturally developed but they are not economically developed, then ultimately that cultural development somehow will demolish. If they are culturally not developed, they are economically developed, then their culture will disappear. Okay, so ultimately, the collective development of the society is very important, and that should be without biasedness. There should not be the tolerance about anything. There should not be a single side development. It should be omnibus. It should be holistic development. So his new socialism was principally aimed at maximum attainable equality, social ownership. Every individual should enjoy the right to owning the things. Small unit technologies are very important, so that most of the people can be employed. Four pillar states, as I already told you, the center, province, district and the villages. A decent standard of living should be provided to every individual, so that he can think outside the box. He can think for the other things, the world parliament and the government. He was an advocate that all the nations of the world should come along and they can work for a big goal. Okay, these are some literary works: the caste system, foreign policy, fragments of world mind, Matriani publishers, fundamental of world mind, guilty men of India's partition, India, China and Northern Frontiers, Interval During Politics, Marx, Gandhi and Socialism. This is a very important book, Marx, Gandhi and Socialism. Through this book, he actually provides his view on the socialism. Okay. So friends, this was all about the lecture. Now, some important questions which can be asked from you. These are, as I have written down in this slide, these are the literary works. You can take the snapshot of this screen. Secondly, Lohia proposed that the decentralized and planned way of economy as proposed by Russia can be a model for India. So does Lohia advocate it, the Russian way? Yes. He says that there should be decentralization in the economics and the planning should be decentralized, and there should be a planning. Sometimes some socialists has also advocated that there should not be a planning. If you plan the economic development, actually you are lowering your thinking. If you are not planning, you can thinking in any way. But Lohia does not prescribe that. He prescribed that there should be a dense, decentralized and planned way of economy. So friends, that's all for the lecture. Thank you.